make some beef.
What we gonna do?
Then they go to dance.
Let you go though.
Well, this week's show is really something special. It's the first day of the conservation season for light geese. Got my buddy Tack Robinson here from Mossy Oak. Jared and Joe scattered them out and put us right on the spot. As Jared says, you fix to see the sky fall.
Make the sky fall, boys.
To see my honey bee, I went down to the South Sea just to see my honey bee. Yeah. My mind was in the heaven, but my feet was on the ground. I was running through the South Sea. My heart began to pound. Oh, but my honeybee is still there. She's waiting there for me.
Told me all about this conservation season. I just had to take him up on it. And, you know, I've been down here several times this fall and over the course of last year, and we see these geese, you know, flying the sky all the way around the place. But obviously we're hunting ducks. But to really concentrate on these geese down here is, I'm telling you, that's something special, something special. And today was a treat. You know, Jared and Joe, those guys put in the homework scouting the geese out, and they had an opportunity to sit in there and hunt with us, and it was just the neatest little old setup. We were hunting right in the edge of this little ditch bank, and about 50 yards out into this winter wheat was, you know, 40 or 50, you know, flags, and I'm telling you, it just couldn't have been any better. Geese just coming, thousands of geese just stringing across the skies, and when they'd see those decoys, they just kind of set their wings, and we'd have a great opportunity to shoot them, and it was a fun morning. Thank you.
This episode of the Honey Break Experience is brought to you by Beretta, 500 years, one passion. Mossy Oak, it's not a passion, it's an obsession. Gator Tail, taking you places you never thought possible. This is the Honey Break Experience.
Day two of the Outlaw Conservation Goose season. And we changed our tactics up a little bit, put the spread out in the field. We got in the ditch. Wind's a little bit different. Geese are coming in early, lighting away from us. We got two pods working. We got a big pod on the water behind us, and they're coming back, trading back and forth. And we are whacking some long shot geese, extended range.
Drew's done a phenomenal job of assembling what I would call the greatest guides in the business. And when you consider the sheer scope of what this property is all about, I mean, you're talking about 40,000 acres of essentially row crop, ag. To put the homework in and know where the geese are gonna, you know, roost and feed and what their habits and traits are, and then be able to make a decision, okay, we're gonna get here because they're gonna be here and we're gonna be in between them. It's just amazing. If you can look at a map and just see how truly spread out it is, it's just truly remarkable that these guys understand it like the back of their hand, and trust me, they do.
Hi, I'm Drew Keith. Here today with good friend Steve Snell from Gun Dog Supply and Joe Perron from Champion Retrievers. What we're going to talk about today is the proper use of check cords and drag lines, and why it's always important to use one of those, Joe.
It's important to use these check cords and drag lines because you keep good control of your dog. You can keep her in the area where you want to train her and give her her commands.
Drew, we like a small snap. With a young dog, we're going to start off with about a 6-foot rope. Mm-hmm. We're going to move up to a 10 or 15 foot as they get a little bit bigger. And then we're going to move up to a larger rope with about a 30 foot. And you want this on your dog all the time when you're doing your basic commands. Mm-hmm. You want to be able to get control over that dog at any point. And the nice thing about a drag line is that as that dog's moving along, instead of calling the dog and the dog not coming to you, you go over there, you pick up the rope. At that point, you call the dog and you can make him come to you.
That's right.
And that way you can always enforce your commands.
That's right.
Here. Here. Good, good girl. Good, good girl. Sit. Sit.
It's a lot like, you know, using a smaller rope like that, so it's, they really don't even notice it's on them.
Exactly.
Until you get ready to reinforce that command. You know, you don't want to start any bad habits off. You want to have good positive habits you want to create. It's your Honey Break Gun Dog Tip of the Week.
You know, these guys are in the duck holes every day, and it's the same old, you know, retrieving a duck out in the water and that type of thing. But you can really see the training that is behind these dogs on the goose field, because it's incredible, you know, taking those, you know, 300 and 400 yard mark and then turning that into a blind retrieve. And you can really see the relationship between the dog and its master at its best on a goose field.
Jared and them scouted out yesterday afternoon, put us right on them. It seems to be working this morning.
It does.
What a difference a day makes.
What about it, Joe? I'm glad you did all that scouting yesterday.
Yeah, I'm glad I'm doing all this shooting.
It's going right at our head, boy.
Get him, boy.
This episode of the Honey Break Experience is brought to you by War Eagle Boats, America's most versatile boat company. K2 Coolers, real value, real cold. Honey Break Lodge and Outfitters, the experience of a lifetime. This is the Honey Break Experience.
Objects may be farther than they appear.
Coming back.
You know, a lot of people just think Honey Break is a place, and I would tell you it's so much more than just a place. It's yeah, it's a place where you can go eat some good food and spend the night and have a good hunt, but it'll be one of the qualitiest outdoor experiences you'll ever have of your life. So I would just encourage anybody who is interested in a family outing, or, you know, whether it be just a quick duck hunt, you know, put Honey Break on your map.
Well, guys, that wraps up another fun day of goose hunting. You know, first day we set up wrong, and the birds were skirting the decoys. Yesterday afternoon, Joe and Jared come out here and scattered them out, put us right on the X marks the spot, and the birds were roosting behind us on the water. Put a smaller spread out, got in the ditch, and cut them off at the pass. Even got a little bonus banded goose.
No doubt.
Tax first bonus banded goose.
Look, you think Miss Sandy's got something?
No doubt about it. Let's get these geese up and get our spread picked up and head on back to the lot.
10-4.
This episode of the Honey Break Experience is brought to you by Drake Waterfowl, innovators in waterfowl hunting. Honey Break Gun Club, Louisiana's finest. Mojo Outdoors, it ain't magic if it ain't mojo. This is the Honey Break Experience.
next time on the Honey Break Experience.
That's killing them dead! That's killing them dead! Yo! Yeah, boy, make the sky fall, boys, make the sky fall.
Bandit, baby, bandit! Only on the Pursuit Channel.